It's a beautiful space. It's a beautiful river.
The Waimakariri is particularly steep by New Zealand standards. It carries a lot of gravel. It's very high energy. In the upper reaches, it's quite braided. The Waimakariri is a particularly aggressive river. In the early days of European settlement in the 1850s, it was recognised by the settlers that they couldn't in fact develop sustainable communities without managing the river and managing that flood risk.
When you look at what the Waimakariri River has historically done, it is a major threat. There's photos of the floods in the late 1800s where there's 2.5 to 3 metres of water flowing through Cathedral Square. So that shows you just the power of the river and the damage it could do to Christchurch.
We're standing on the primary stop bank at Inglebrecks. This is ground zero in the river engineering sense. The river broke out through the stop bank in 1957 and caused flooding in Lower Coots Island and through the Belfast area right out towards Spencerville.
The project's been subject to quite rigorous project management. A huge amount of planning, of working out where water could flow in a given event, making sure that the primary stop banks that were in place were up to scratch, would perform how they would perform, and then providing a secondary flow pass and secondary stop banks in behind them to really provide a belt and braces approach.
Working out from hydraulic modelling how high flood levels get and where floodwaters go and working out how we contain those floodwaters.
It's a very clever piece of engineering, very clever piece of thinking about how to manage a massive, beautiful braided river.
In terms of the primary stop bank, we had to upgrade 35 kilometres. We had to construct 25 kilometres of secondary stop bank. In terms of rock armouring, we constructed rock riverbank protection, and that involved 260,000 tonnes of quarried rock.
The primary system is designed for a flood event of 5,500 cumecs of water. That's a lot of water. The secondary system has been designed for 6,500 cumecs of water.
1 cubic metre is, of course, a tonne of water, so that's equivalent to the weight of a Honda Civic. So 5,500 cubic metres per second is equivalent to 5,500 Honda Civics going past.
We have confidence that what we've designed is going to work.
The budget for the project was $40 million. It was to be rolled out over 10 years, kicking off in 2010. We're on target in terms of budget, and it's a very pleasing situation for us to be in.
I also have to pay credit not only to the project managers but also to the contractors who have been involved all the way through.
Without a flood protection system in place, there's at least $8 billion of asset at risk on the floodplain.
It's about looking after our backyard, turning a risk in our backyard to an asset. And now we've seen through this project, we've been able to accelerate the development of those areas and create quite unique recreational assets and biodiversity assets for the people of Greater Christchurch.
It's the wildness of the river that makes it so attractive to the local community. On a nice day, I love it. It'll terrify me when it's in flood.
There are always likely to be challenges in the future. There might be the super flood, or there might be what climate change brings us in decades to come. But what we know is that we've created an asset here that is a legacy, a foundation legacy for the future.